Hello there, welcome to my class. Today we'll talk about...
In today's video, we'll be dealing with the design of combinational circuits, specifically for multiplexers. So, what are multiplexers? Multiplexers are electronic circuits that have multiple inputs and one output only. Multiplexers will select from multiple inputs which will be connected to our output. Let's deal with this multiplexer which has two inputs. We have I0 and I1. Then only one of these two inputs will be connected to the output with the conditions that will be set by our select pin S. For example, if we let select pin be equivalent to 0, I1 will already be deactivated because the output of I1 will always be equivalent to 0 no matter what is our input. However, since our select pin is equal to 0, inverted will become 1. Therefore, the other input for this AND gate coming from our select pin will be equal to 1. Our output here, therefore, will be dependent on whatever our input at I0. If we try to analyze that, the output, therefore, will be equal to whatever our input I0. With it, therefore, the multiplexer was able to select that the input that will be connected to our output will be I0. In communication, multiplexers are very useful. If we try to consider our cell phones, for example, we call at the same time using a single channel, but there is no problem as to where our signal will go or who will be communicating simply because we have a multiplexer to do that. At a given time, one caller will be identified, which will be connected to our line, and the rest will be muted. That is one of the primary functions of our multiplexer. If there is therefore a multiplexer, we have also what we call a demultiplexer. What's the function of the multiplexer? The multiplexer will have one input only, while there will be multiple output. The output will be connected to one of the output depending on our select pin. So it is therefore the reverse of a multiplexer. So in communication again, there is a single chip that will have a multiplexer and a demultiplexer in order for that circuit to connect multiple output to a single input and from a single input to a multiple output. So here is the block diagram of the multiplexer. We have the select pin responsible in determining where our single input will be connected, whether it's I0 or I1. For example, this time, let's say S is equal to 1. And if S is equal to 1, then our input here will be equal to 1, while our input here will be equal to 0. Since this is 0, then as if saying that our AND gate going into our I/O is deactivated, whereas our AND gate to the output 1 will be activated, thereby making our output here will be equivalent to X. So let's try to design some multiplexer. Let's deal with a 4x1 multiplexer. 4x1 multiplexer will have 4 input that will be connected to a single output. Since it is 4x1, the number of select pin will be 2 select pin. 2 raised to 2, since there are 2 select pin, then that will be equal to 4. We'll be having 4 input connected to a single output. We try to observe the circuit for our select pin. It is a plain and simple decoder. Since there are 2 select pin, there will be 4 possible combinations. For this AND gate, that will be connected to 0, 0. That's why I marked it 0. Then this one will be 0, 1, 1. This will be 1 and 0, that is equal to 2. And this will be 1, 1. These 3 AND gates will be activated depending on our select pin. Analyzing it again, this is but a plain and simple decoder. If we are to make it as a multiplexer, then we'll be needing 4 possible input. That is I0, I1, I2, and I3 connected to the 4 AND gates. So that there will be only one output, we'll be needing an OR gate connected to the 4 AND gates. Let's try to design an 8x1 multiplexer. In designing an 8x1 multiplexer, we'd be needing 2 4x1 multiplexer and 2x1 multiplexer. Definitely, the 4x1 multiplexer will have 4 input each. The first multiplexer will have the input I0 to I3 and the next multiplexer will have input I4 to I7. For these two multiplexers, we'd be needing two select pins, S1 and S0. If, for example, our input S0 and S1 is equal to 0, 0, then we'll be selecting I0 and I4 at the same time. So, we know for a fact that only one will be connected to the output. It cannot be that I0 and I4 will be connected at the same time at the output. Then we'll be violating our design, that is 8x1 multiplexer. It should be connected to a single output only. So that will be the responsibility of our multiplexer having another select pin, S2. And if S2, for example, is equal to 0, then we'll be selecting the first multiplexer. And if S2 is equal to 1, then we'll be selecting the next multiplexer. To simulate our multiplexer, how, for example, since we have 8x1 multiplexer, we'd be needing 3 select pins because 2 raised to 3 will be equal to 8. So let's try to simulate 0, 1, 0. So S1 and S0 is equal to 1, 0. Since this is 1, 0, then we'll be selecting I2 and I6 with respect to S0 and S1. Problem is, we cannot have I2 and I6 be connected at the same time to the output. So it will be the responsibility of our 2x1 multiplexer, which of these two will be selected. So since S2 is equal to 0, then it will be I2 that will be selected. Let's try to simulate another. For example, we have 111. We know that 111 is equal to 7. Let's try to see if I7 will be selected. Since this is 11, S1 and S0 is 11, then it will be I3 and I7 that will be selected by S1 and S0. It cannot be that I3 and I7 will be connected to the output. So it will be the responsibility of our 2x1 multiplexer to select whether it's I3 or I7. Since S2 is equal to 1, then this multiplexer will be selected. It is therefore I7 that will be connected to the output. What we are trying to design is an 8x1 multiplexer. So an 8x1 multiplexer has 8 inputs, I0 to I7, and 1 output, making the number of pins required by our chip or integrated circuit be equivalent already to 9. We have to add still our supply, power supply, that is our VCC and our ground. Then that makes it 9 plus 2 equivalent to 11. We'd be needing, therefore, an integrated circuit with at least 12 pins. So let's try to design, for example, a 32x1 multiplexer. Since that is 32, we'd be needing 4 8x1 multiplexer because 8 times 4 is equal to 32. Each of these multiplexer will have 8 input each, so that is I0 to I7. The first multiplexer will have I0 to I7. The next multiplexer will have I8 to I15. The next will be I16 to 23 and I24 to 31. Since there are 4 multiplexer, we'd be needing another 4x1 multiplexer so that this 4x1 multiplexer will be the one to responsible in selecting whether it's multiplexer 00, 01, 10, or 11 that will be connected to our. How many select pins do we need for 32? Using 2 raised to n again, we need n to be equivalent to 5 so that 2 raised to 5 will be equal to 32. So for the 8x1, we'll be using 3 select pins, so S0, S1, and S2 to determine which of the 8 inputs of the different multiplexers will be connected to our 4x1 multiplexer. And the 4x1 multiplexer will use 2 select pins, so that will be S3 and S4, to select whether it's 00, 01, 10, or 11. 8x1 multiplexer will be selected. Example, if it is S3 and S4 is equal to 00, then this will be selected. Then this is 01, this is 10, and this will be 11. Again, let's try to simulate our 32x1 multiplexer. As an example, let's use 9 and 31. What is 9? 4, that will be 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. This is 1 plus 8 is equivalent to 9. For our 8x1 multiplexer, we'll be having the value for S2, S1, and S0 be equivalent to 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. Since it is 0, 0, 1, then I1 will be selected. So it will be I1, I9, I17, and I25 that will be selected. With these four selected by S0, S1, and S2, we'd be needing only one of them to be connected to our output. The responsibility of that is now passed to the selector pin S3 and S4. So since S3 and S4 is equal to 0, 1, then the second multiplexer therefore will be selected, marked as 0, 1. So it will only be I9 that will be connected to our output. Let's try to simulate 31. 31 will be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. That is 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16 is equal to 31. With it, the select pin S2, S1, and S0 will be equivalent to 111. Since this is 111, then it will be I7. Of all the 8 multiplexers will be selected. However, only one will be connected to our output, and that is now the responsibility of S3 and S4. And S3 and S4 is also equal to 11. So it will be this multiplexer that will be selected. It will be I31, therefore, that will be connected to our output. Putting our design in a single chip, we'll be having 32 inputs and one output that will already be 33, plus our supply, VCC and ground, then that will be equivalent to 35. We'd be needing at least a single integrated circuit with 36 pins each. 18, if we are going to use DIP, dual inline package integrated circuit, then we'll be needing 18 pins here and another 18 pins here. So that will use therefore 36 pins. We try to observe what happened with our 4x1, 8x1, and 32x1 multiplexer. We'll be having an increase in the number of pins of our integrated circuit. Increasing the number of pins of our integrated circuit will make the size of integrated circuit be larger, because the pins of our integrated circuit cannot be easily reduced. What shall we do so that we'll not be using a very large integrated circuit? We will use this 8x1 multiplexer and 4x1 multiplexer to make a 32x1 multiplexer. We are only designing a 32x1 multiplexer. How about if we design 64? How about if we design 128x1 multiplexer? It will be the number of pins, therefore, will continue to increase. That is what we are avoiding in the design of our multiplexer. We'll be using also multiplexer in the design of our digital circuits. So follow me in my next video on how are we going to use our multiplexer in the design of a digital circuit.